All right, we are back on Saturday Night, and as you saw just a moment ago, we have brand new, some of the top wrestling stars from around the world will be coming into World Championship Wrestling in the next couple of weeks, next couple of months. It starts, of course, as we bring in a new man that you saw earlier called Disco Inferno, who's going to be coming to World Championship Wrestling very soon.
I like disco music.
I bet you do.
I do.
The decade that tastes forgot. The Pit Bull, Sergeant Craig Pittman against Terry Morgan in this one-on-one matchup. As a matter of fact, as we said, from all over the world, you are going to be seen here on all of our programs Saturday night, the Pro on Saturday morning, Sunday night on the main event, and of course on WCW Monday Nitro on TNT, the top new stars from around the world coming to World Championship Wrestling.
Let me make one thing clear right now, Shivani. As soon as I leave here, I'm going to fly to Minneapolis because I'm going to get ready for tomorrow night's main event. Now, if McNuggets wants to show up there, he can. So I'm going to give him one weekend. Just one weekend here at WCW to enjoy himself. But then Monday, at Monday Nitro from the Mall of America, I am going to be there, Shivani, live and in living color. And if Steve McMichaels or McNuggets or whoever he thinks he is going to make a reputation of me, I'll tell you something, pigskin man. You're going to go back and sit on the bench where you belong, because you think you're out of your league when you mess with Bobby, the Brain Heenan. I'm the man that made the Twin Cities famous.
Oh, you did?
Yeah, take it.
We're going to be going back out to the Twin Cities. As a matter of fact, they planted Hollywood, Eric Bischoff, and Sting out there with Eric, the Macho Man, Randy Savage, Hulk Hogan out there, of course, the world champion Hulk Hogan will lead his troops in the battle at War Games, but also he'll be on WCW Monday Nitro on TNT in the main event against Big Bubba this coming Monday. And I tell you, War Games, the match beyond. Hulk Hogan, what a battle it's going to be, and what intrigue. Can he trust Big Van Vader? What about Cobra and the Pitbull, Craig Pittman?
I found something out about that.
What?
From my sources, I found out that during the Gulf War, Pittman here was supposed to make sure all his brigade or platoon got back. Well, somehow the Cobra got disorientated and got lost. He went back and said Cobra was back with him and then put him down as AWOL when they went to find him and couldn't find him. He got him, the man almost court-martialed. That's the word I get. But I don't believe it, because I asked the sergeant about it, and he said, that's a lie. I said, it's good enough for me.
You're starting something again is what you're doing. Why do you bring information up like that when you know it probably isn't true? You're starting things. You're starting trouble. And I can tell you, you're not going to be able to start trouble with Steve McMichael.
Well, there's a good chance it could be true. A real good chance.
And there's the code red. It's a good chance this one could be over. It is.
There's a good chance I could take McMichael's tongue right out of his mouth and pat it on his shoulder pads.
Wow.
And maybe what he'd do. Nothing.
Your winner of the Pit Bull, Craig Pittman.
Another undisciplined civilian. That's meditating.
All right. He is your winner. We're going back to Eric and Steve at the Mall of America. And Planet Hollywood in just a few moments. Here it is again, Brain.
Pittman is always on alert. He's always watching because he knows Cobra somewhere around. Did he desert Cobra? Did he leave him in the hot desert to fend for himself? Did he write him down as AWOL? Did he turn his back on his own troops? He tells me he didn't. I think Cobra's a liar.
Still to come, Mean Gene Okerlund, our Fall Brawl Control Center, and our big main event. But right now, Eric, have you been listening to what Brain has been saying about Steve McMichael?